Hey up, welcome back to the Mac A Workshop again, and thank you for joining me. Right, this Hacker RP1 Harrier, we're going to disassemble it. So it says here, remove the back cover and take out the batteries. Let's have a go at that. Obviously no batteries in it. Take out the handle fixing screws, noting the sequence of the spacing washers for reassembly. Unplug the connectors from the speaker. Hang on, let's get these screws out the side. Oh, look, very nice screws they are too. Get the right size screwdriver. Noting where the washers go. Okay, so it's got a grommet in the middle, a washer on that side, and here there's a rubber washer, and that's it. So it goes like that. Okay, let's put that on one side and make sure we lose it so we can't find it later. Let's pull the other one. What could possibly go wrong? Right, set the handle off, all very nice and clean. So yeah, that washer does actually come off. Let's see if we can get it off this side. There we go, off she comes. Okay. So if you can hear any background noise, it sounds like my neighbour has taken up a demolition. Okay, what does it say now? We've done that. Unplug the connections from the speakers. Okay. There's one, there's two. I have taken the precaution of putting a black mark on this, so not that it matters, just so it goes back in the right order. Power supply unit, aerial leads to the tuner. Power supply, oh that's all in this side, isn't it? Right, we better make a note of where all this stuff goes actually before we start going all crazy and unplugging it all. Okay, I'm going to pause while I make a note where all these wires go here. Right, okay, I've made a note where these wires go. Let's pull them off. White one and green one, that's them off. Let's pull this. Blimey, that doesn't want to come off. Okay, let's not force it, let's leave that there for now. It doesn't tell you on here, but I think we're going to have to unscrew this aerial. Let's do that now. I can leave that in there. It probably. Oh no. Oh, blimey. Yeah, let's leave that in there. It's all getting a bit looser now. Let's start to lift this chassis out and see what's left that's connected. Okay. So yeah, it was just that there, which was a bit awkward to get at. Oh, there we go. So that's chassis out. Okay, great stuff. Let's put this on one side. And let's have a look at this chassis. Move the tools out of the way. Oh yeah, so what I want to do now, because this is just a servicing exercise, we want to be changing these electrolytic capacitors. Not much to it. What I'll do is, I haven't actually found the values yet, so like I say, I'm just going to look up each capacitor, draw a line and then put the value next to it for all the capacitors before we go any further. So I'll just pause again, guys. Okay, I've had a look and I've noted down all the values of these caps that we're going to replace. So there's 10 of them actually. I think 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. The only one I haven't got that's axial is the 470 that's going to replace a 400. Well, I've got a Nichicon there that it'll go in alright because I think it's one of these two that stood up. So I'm warming up the soldering iron and I'll just change all these caps. There's no point in videoing that. You've seen me do it on other videos. It's basically unsolder one and you put the replacement back in. We'll test these after to see. I am going to do them all. We'll test these after to see if any were really out of spec. I should imagine they're all leaky, and as this is a service, it's best to replace them. Mainly Vishay caps to go in, so it'll still look nice and blue inside. Okay. So, just a note of interest, I'm not going to do this on every cap, but I've started with this 6.4 cap at the back here. I like to start with the ones that are most inaccessible, and then work away to the edge of the board, gets easier. So this 6.4, so I'm not going to do this with every single cap, it just gets a bit boring watching it on YouTube over and over again, people recapping. So that's supposed to be 6.4. Is this just, it doesn't test ESR this, it just tests the actual capacitance. And you can see that was well out. I'm putting a 6.8 Nichicon in. Luckily that one's hidden behind these wires, so the rest are all going to be these blue Vishays. So it'll look nice. You're not really going to see this one back there, but let's just put this one on the meter anyway. 6.8, that's bang on what it should be. It won't be leaky and it won't do the radio any harm. The only thing is, this one is a surface mount cap, not an axial. So what I'm going to do now is see which is positive and negative on this. I just use this one that's come out, put it down so you can see, just to bend the legs on this so they're at the right angle before popping it back in. Okay, next time you see it, all these caps will be replaced, and then we can give it a spin and put it back together. This one, it'll just have been basically serviced. You kind of knew I'd have to waffle on a little bit more about these caps, so that's what I've done with the legs on that one to make it match up. Just so you can see, then when it goes back in, it's nice and neat. Okay. So just continuing on through this board to recap it, I've started this way, working way across this way. Just got to these guys that are stood upright on the board, and they have this little rubber washer on the bottom. I've not seen that before, to be honest. But what I am going to do is reuse that. It must be there for a reason. That's this one that we're on at the moment, which is a, is it a 250? I can't remember, let's have a look. Yeah, it's a 250, and that's another thing as well. I've tried to keep all the blue Vishays in, but the only 250s I've got in stock are these ones, which are black. They're a very good capacitor. So these are all going to be blue. These are blue, black down here. So it's going to look... It's going to look okay when it's finished. I'd like to keep the colour, because when you pull the back off, I mean, to some people it doesn't matter. You can put any old capacitor, sorry, not any old capacitor, any new capacitor in, and as long as it works, that's fine. I kind of like to be a bit more sympathetical with them and try to keep the colour scheme the same. But hey ho. So yeah, I just haven't seen one of them before. The other thing I want to say, if you're just starting out in this this changing capacitor world, this is a particularly easy board to work on, the Hacker Harrier. If you wanted to make it one of your first projects, like a simple servicing job like I'm doing, I would recommend the Hacker Harrier. So easy to work on. Okay, let's carry on. Right, okay, there we go. That's all them caps done. Doesn't look too bad, does it? I have put them little rubber washers back on underneath. They must have been there for a reason. Who knows? Who knows? But they've gone back on anyway. That's it really. I suppose we should get this all back together and see if we broke it. That'd be funny if it wouldn't work now. Saying that, when I took it out of storage, I've not even tested it. Not sure. What I'll do, I'll just stand all these other components up. I was looking before at this test link here. That looks a right thick thing. It looks like you have to unsolder that if you want to take the test link out. Not sure we'll be going that far with this one. Should we have a quick look under there? Make sure it's all nice and clean. It is, it's not. I think, what did we say, 1970 something? I'm not going to do a cosmetic on this because it doesn't need it. Really doesn't need it. It looks pretty smart anyway. Right, let's get the case again. Let's see if we can get this back in. Should be pretty straightforward. Let's zoom you out a little bit. Manually zoom you out. It goes in. Kind of like this way. I was working on it, this fella. I've been informed that it takes 4 station markers, this. Don't have any spares. So this one's... Is that right? That doesn't look right, is it? Is that how it goes? Yep. Must be. Yep, that's how that goes. Yeah, so it's got a little rail there that this marker moves along. Right, let's turn it over and let's see what we've trapped. Speaker wires. Let's see what else we've trapped there at the front. Oh no, we haven't trapped them, it's just quite a short lead. Right, it's plenty enough to fit though. So let's connect them back in. Right, just letting the camera roll a little bit. Alright, let's get, how can we get, perhaps we should have done that while it was, I didn't say there wasn't much speaker wires, to get this little plug back in, just move the board up a bit so we can get it in. Are we in shot there? I can see what I'm doing. What have we got now? We've got a black wire, why, oh, I made a little diagram of them, didn't I, so we know where they went. Let's have a look. So the white wire went on the top of that terminal there, and the green one went on the other terminal. Just come on, get on you. Nearly swore then. Forgetting the camera's rolling. Okay, and this black wire goes onto this terminal here. Let's just get that out so we can connect it. Drop the screw. Oh, that covers up the hole. Where did the screw go? There it is. Let's get that into position. I'll stop the camera going in a minute while I put the handle back on. Well, this has been a pain. So that goes onto there. And then that. This is, it looks like a ground wire that goes all the way to the speaker, this one. Can we get it back in? Come on. Say, I'm at a funny angle working while the camera rolls. Always a funny angle. But I just thought I'd let it roll a little bit because I've not done that for a while in a video. Just let it roll while I'm doing these little bits. Oh, I see it's come off again. And this is one of the reasons why I don't let it roll. As soon as you do, the set starts misbehaving, starts being a a fiddly pain. Right, let's try again. All this is one connection. Right, I'm gonna see, it's come off again. I'm going to bend that out a little bit so it's easy to get on the gate. This screw in. And then try to get the wire back on again at this funny angle. Right, that's that. Wrong size screwdriver. Come on, Mr. Man Cave. You can do it. Make sure that's nice and tight in there. It is. And then that bit sits on there. Somehow. Doesn't seem very secure, that. That's how it went. Right. Let's get the radio back in its case. I say they are easy to work on, these. Very easy to work on. Right, I'm gonna get the handle back on. Actually, no, let me test it now, because, and you can see I haven't pre-tested it. It wants to have, that was on. Okay, it wants 9 volts. So there we go. 9 volts going in. Seems to work. Seems to work. Right, okay, there we go. There's all the old caps we took out. It was 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. All out of spec, all bad. Let's pop a PP9 battery in it, because it only needs one to work. Is it off? Yeah, off now. That doesn't grip on this side very well. We've got to got it at hand, so we can just make that a bit more grippy. Let's just close these up a little bit. Probably too much now. Oh, that's better. Let's pop that in there. Is it? Does it go that way? This way? That way? There we go. That fits nice as well. Let's put the back on. We know it works because we just tested it on the DC power supply. But let's give it another spin. Alright, let's put the aerial up.
Right, let's check in with Jill. Hello, Jill. She says, give me a mention, please. I absolutely love Smooth Radio. That's nice to know. And I'm on a well-earned day off from the NHS. Just the one day, eh, Jill?
You what, sliding into the DMs?
Why are you looking at me when you said that?
Because you know he's true.
Discover all the stuff that you never normally get to hear.
Oh, it picks up Classic FM. I do like that station. And Radio 3. That's good enough for me. And Radio 4 as well, we heard that before. Can't leave it on the music too long.
Really not anything to do. Don't say anymore. You're protesting too much.
Yeah, I'm happy with that. There's no cosmetic work to do with this radio. It's just a simple electrolytic capacitor service on it. So, as always, thank you for watching. Stay safe in these troubled times. And be good to each other. I'll catch you next time. Take care.